What's going on, guys? Welcome back into the channel. Today we're going to be doing two videos, and in the first video here we're going to be breaking down essentially the basics of Road to the Show in MLB The Show 21. What's changed, you know, how to progress your player and things like that, or rather breaking down the archetypes and all that stuff. And we're going to give you essentially my guide to Road to the Show in order for you to get the best start in a Road to the Show if you're considering playing it at this point or maybe making a new one. So let's go ahead and jump into it. Now, the first thing that I recommend that you guys do whenever you're going into a Road to the Show is go out and get one of the rosters that are out there and available from other people. You know, we're going to dive deeper into that in video number two today, which is tips, you know, essentially my most important tips for getting ahead in Road to the Show. But if you guys go up to essentially the create tab up at the top right hand corner of the screen, and then you go to the vaults, you'll be able to select from various different rosters that are out there. Find yourself a roster that has the minor league players, you know, the full minors out there. There are a couple. The one that I'm using is called Ed's Full Minors or something like that. Whenever Scout Scoops and Ride'em Rosters finally releases their roster at the end of this week, I'll probably be using that roster, so be on the lookout for that. But that's going to give you basically the best experience, most realistic experience in Road to the Show. You'll have all the correct prospects around you and things like that. You're not going to be having to compete with as many auto-generated prospects, which can tend to be a little OP and kind of mess things up as you go through your Road to the Show, can prevent you from progressing and things like that. So get yourself a roster as tip number one, and point number one within this guide. Then whenever you go to actually start a Road to the Show, it's going to prompt you to set up your ball player. Now there's a couple of things that we want to go through here today with the ball player that are critically important to understand whenever you're going through Road to the Show, basically to understand how you're going to progress as a player and, you know, basically how you're going to get called up in the future, because your overall plays a big part in terms of how you're actually going to get called up. So when you go to select your ball player here, you can create a couple of different loadouts. Now, one thing that I didn't understand whenever I first started was that you can create multiple loadouts and select them in game depending on what you're actually doing. So basically what you want to do is you want to, if you're doing a two-way player, have one hitting loadout and one pitching loadout. The mistake that I made whenever I first started was I had one loadout that I was trying to utilize for both my third baseman and my starting pitcher, and that's going to create issues for you. You know, you're not going to get the most out of your player whenever you're on the mound or whenever you're in the field or whenever you're at bat. You try to create two different loadouts here. I have one for pitching and one for my third baseman, and that makes things so much easier, and you're going to get better core stats whenever you do that. And the reason for that is you're going to have specialized core stats, you know. So for my position player, I have a better arm, better power, and then whenever I actually play as a pitcher, I'm going to get those nice, you know, stats like velocity, Ks per nine, stamina, control break, all that good stuff. Make sure you have two separate loadouts at least. You can create multiple loadouts, and we'll get more into what loadouts you want to do whenever I get into my tips video, but essentially you want to have two loadouts. And you also want to understand that the archetype system works differently this year. So in previous years, whenever you started a Road to the Show, you didn't have this My Ball Player option. Whenever you started a Road to the Show, it would give you an option of what type of player you'd want to be. You could select from like a power hitter, contact hitter, whether you wanted to be a velocity pitcher, break pitcher, whatever. You got to select from an archetype, and then you got to upgrade traits as you went along. However, from this, you know, new system, your ball player is going to be what's utilized across all game modes. So, you know, these attributes, these archetypes are going to essentially be what's utilized in both Road to the Show, Diamond Dynasty, and anywhere else you might use My Ball Player at. So you have to understand that these don't level up quite the same way. And the big trait at the top here is going to be your archetype. And so these archetypes are incredibly important because whenever you hit View Program on them, you can level these archetypes up. Now, as you guys can see, I have a couple of gold archetypes, a couple of diamond archetypes, And you can see right there in the middle of the screen, my overall changes depending on which archetype I have. Now we'll get more into this in my tips video specifically, but just know that you need to level up your archetype as you go along to silver, gold, diamond, and that is part of the way that you're going to increase your overall within Road to the Show. It is no longer simply a progression within Road to the Show where you get hits, you strike people out, and your attributes upgrade based on that. They upgrade based on the training you do in between games. That's not how it works 100% anymore. Now you have these archetypes where you can hit square, or I'm assuming that's X on Xbox. You can view the program for them, and you do all of these various challenges to earn points to upgrade your archetypes. And once you upgrade an archetype all the way, it's going to give you the next level. So Slugger, what I'm using right now, is at bronze. Whenever I level it up all the way to 100 points, I'm going to get a silver archetype based off of that. And when you level up that archetype, you're going to get a couple of archetypes on top of that. So the first archetype that I used was Spark Plug. And whenever I upgraded Spark Plug, it gave me Slick Spark Plug, Slugging Spark Plug, and Speedy Spark Plug. And then from those three, you can choose to level up whatever three you want. From there, I upgraded the Speedy Spark Plug, which gave me the Spoke and Rawhide, and then I upgraded the Spoke from there and got the Diamond Spoke. So you just have to understand that your archetypes this year work differently than they did in the past. And on top of that, you're going to have a very similar system to your traits that you can add on to that. Now, these are, equipable, same leveling system and everything. You get the bronze, the silver, the gold, and these are all going to determine your ratings. And so as I scroll through here, you're going to see that certain ones make my overall go up a little bit more, and your overall is going to determine how quickly you get called up into the show or to AAA and then to the show after that. Then, once you've created your ball players and your loadouts to your liking, make sure that you guys go ahead and load the roster that you've selected as your option for your roster. So for this one specifically, I'm going to go ahead and you guys can see I have Ed's Full Miners Roster 2.0. I'm going to go ahead and load that up so that I have that roster available to me, those players around me, and it's going to give me essentially the best, most realistic experience as we go along. Now, in my next video today, I'm going to talk a little bit more about some of these choices, specifically selecting a club or whatever. If you want to have the most realistic experience, it might just benefit you to, basically say, I just want to play for whatever team and don't select a specific ball club. That doesn't matter. That's up to you. Like I said, I'm going to give you a couple of recommendations in the next video, so stay tuned for that. But we're just going to pretty much advance past the stage and let a team select us. Next, you're going to come to the screen where they're going to be asking you whether you want to become a two-way player or not. My recommendation for you is to know early on and ahead of time what you want to do with your Road to the Show player, because you're not going to get a lot of opportunities to switch what you're doing. You get a couple of opportunities throughout, mid-season and stuff like that, but as you begin to progress with your player, you're not going to have a lot of opportunities to switch what you're doing. So think about it ahead of time, whether you want to be a two-way player or not, and think about the type of balance that you want to have whenever going in. In addition to that, I recommend that you plan ahead in terms of what position you think is going to be best for you and link that up with the archetypes that you are selecting. I'm going to give some specific examples and some specific advice in video number two today, talking about the best archetypes for each position and things like that. In today's video, I'm just going to go ahead and select third baseman because that's a pretty standard one for me to select. That's one that I like to play quite a bit. And then you're going to go ahead and you're going to essentially get one more option once you go and play a couple of games here. So after you play your first pitching appearance and then a couple of hitting appearances, it's going to give you another option to select how much you want to play at each position. So again, this is what's going to pop up after a couple of games. You're going to pitch one appearance. You're going to be in you're going to bat and field for two games, and then you're going to pop up with this decision. You're going to have the option to select what you want to do. You can discuss your exact roles. You can discuss how much you want to focus on hitting or pitching. Within these options, generally speaking, like I said, you kind of want to know ahead of time what you want to focus on. My recommendation, I'll give this one a little bit early, but I'll elaborate on it more within video number two today, is I like to say, I want to pitch in the starting rotation and then hit and field in between appearances on the hill. Like I said, I'm going to elaborate more on that, but that's going to maximize your time if you want to be a two-way player. I made the mistake within my first one of saying I'd like to focus mostly on hitting and position play, but also pitch occasionally in between, and I didn't get a lot of opportunities to actually pitch. And so that's why I say to go with this one. I'm going to elaborate on that more, like I said, and then we're going to go ahead and get into the next, basically the next piece of this guide here. The next and probably honestly most important piece of this guide today is if you have not started a Road to the Show yet, you want to restart your Road to the Show or start a new one, because they patched in the option to add pitches to your repertoire. You did not have this option if you started a Road to the Show whenever the game came out, and this is the main reason that I personally restarted my Road to the Show, because I wanted to be able to add pitches to my arsenal. And so you now have the ability to through the bullpen training. Don't forget to do your training and focus on the core attributes, the physical attributes that are most important to you. A lot of the attributes you can progress through the game by getting strikeouts, by getting hits and things like that. You know, from my experience, things like contact, plate vision, Ks per nine, BB per nine, those things are pretty easy to increase. The things that are hard to increase and really you don't increase through a game all that much are, you know, physical attributes like four-seam fastball velocity, your control, your break, and then, you know, from other perspectives, if you're taking a look at like your power, if you're taking a look at your speed, those are the things you should try to upgrade when you have the opportunities to get them over top of these other intangible attributes, because they're harder to come by, and the options to upgrade them do not always pop up whenever you're actually in the bullpen or batting cage training or whatever, you know, training you're trying to do. Those things are really important. You know, arm strength from a fielding perspective, those types of things, focus on those whenever you're getting the opportunities to do these trainings, because you can't necessarily upgrade them as easily by simply playing. And then the last thing that I want to talk about today is just paying attention to the roster that you are on. It is extremely important that you pay attention to who is on the roster ahead of you at the positions that you're trying to progress through. So, for example, let's say I wanted to become the starting third baseman in the major leagues. Well, if this team has Chris Bryant ahead of me, they're pretty unlikely to move him in order to bring me up and put me in his place. Now, he's on the injured reserve list, so there's the potential that I could come up and replace him because of his injury. But if you have a lot of competition ahead of you at the position that you are at, you may want to consider seeking a trade or restarting to try to get drafted to a team that doesn't have quite as much competition. You want to pay attention to these things, because there's a lot of people, friends, everything included, that I see kind of just jump in to where they're drafted, and they try to work their way up. And the problem is, you're never going to get called up if there's just fantastic players ahead of you. You need to at least consider seeking a trade. Like I said, we'll talk a little bit more about tips to avoid getting stuck behind other players in video number two today, but that's the last thing that I wanted to talk about, was, you know, talk about the roster and paying attention to that. And then here's the final point that I want to make, is that you need to pay attention to your overall in comparison to the other players. And this directly relates to the roster, so it's kind of the same point, but your overall is going to be directly tied to how likely they are to call you up to the major league. And so, you know, from a perspective of your both your batter and your pitcher, you're going to have two different overalls. And so my ball player here as a position player is a 79. If I go as a starting pitcher, he's also a 79. So pretty likely to get called up because he's a pretty high overall, and a higher overall than most of the other players in the organization. However, you know, this is highly dependent on multiple things within the game. This is dependent on your progression through the game itself, through Road to the Show. It's based on your progression in terms of getting better archetypes, upgrading your archetypes, and upgrading your traits that are attached to them, as well as this is you know, dependent on the equipment that you have. So your equipment doesn't necessarily inflate your rating right now. It's kind of glitched where, you know, I have these pieces of equipment on me that aren't directly showing an overall increase, but I can tell you for a fact that it is going to change the way the organization looks at you. If you have all of these bonus stats from this equipment that you have, you know, on your player, they do factor in. So it's not directly showing up on your playing card here, but what it does show up as is all of those pluses above the bars. So the way to look at this is your contact is 57, but my equipment is giving plus 16 on top of that 57 whenever I'm batting. So you have to understand that your equipment is adding huge boosts to your player. So while it says you're a 79, you're actually much higher overall than that 79 or whatever overall you're sitting at. So highly important that you pay attention to your overall and you try to boost your player's stats as much as possible through the various different methods there to you, whether it be completing the programs and getting better traits to put on your player or getting better equipment through the other modes, you know, Diamond Dynasty and stuff like that. It's very important that you focus on that and then focus on that in comparison to the roster and the competition that is around you and ahead of you, and that's going to determine whether you get called up or not. And with all that being said, hopefully this video helped you guys out. Like I said, more of just a basic guide. Stay tuned for video number 2, where I'm going to give you guys some specific tips to help improve your basically time here within Road to the Show. Going to help you get called up faster, going to improve your, you know, progression through Road to the Show, boost your overall, all that good stuff. I'm going to give you some, you know, very easy tips to help you out whenever you're going through Road to the Show to help boost your player. And make sure you guys, like I said, stay tuned to that. Leave a like on this video if this helped you guys out. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. Comment down below with anything you guys could use help with or you'd like to see next. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Hope you guys have a good one.